Hello guys and welcome back. If this is your first time, I hope you will stay. Espero que te quedes. Okay, so today I'm going to teach you a little bit about the prepositions para and por, which you can translate to English as for, generally. But we do get confused with these two words because they are so similar. And it's very easy to get them confused because I did. I used to do this all the time in lower school. So I hope this video will be useful to you. Okay, I'm going to start with por. When do we use por? Por motivo. So reasons, okay? We're going to start with the first point. A favor de. So in favor of someone. So for example, you'd say, lo hice por ti. Y por mi madre. So who are you doing it for? You're doing it for someone. Lo hice por ti. Okay? Lo hice por ti. Okay. Segundo punto. Lugar donde se pasa. Okay? Tom quiere pasar por Sevilla antes de llegar a Albacete. So you're passing from one place through another. So you're passing through a city. Okay? You're passing through a place. That example. Do you get what I mean? Okay, right. Parte del día. We use por to talk about, for instance, you could say por las mañanas, in the mornings, por las tardes, or por las noches. Okay? Right here. And when you are about to do something, a punto de realizar una acción, estamos por llegar. Okay, so you're just about to do something. You're about to arrive. So that's when you would use por. On the other hand, you have para, which is por una finalidad, an aim. Okay, so we have opinión on my first point. So your opinion. So para nosotros, el inglés es muy importante, okay? For us, es muy importante, it's an opinion, it's our opinion, okay? Objetivo. So what? Why are you there to do something? Viene aquí para aprender. Viene aquí para aprender. So he comes here to learn. And here, the for would actually be translated as to. He comes here to learn. Okay? Uso. So use. What's the use of something? Este boli, bolígrafo, este boli es para dibujar. El boli es para dibujar. That is its use. Okay? That's what it's used for. Plazo límite. Okay? So, a time limit. Mi jefe dice que el informe es para el martes. Okay, so we're talking about a deadline now. It's for Monday. Tuesday, rather. It's for Tuesday. Okay, and last point I have here, destino. Okay, where's the destination? El autobús, I forgot the accent, el autobús va para Bristol. Where is it heading to? He's heading to Bristol. Okay, so we'll use it in that case. Points, para, destination, places, times, people, and goal. Okay? Por, okay, so through time and space. Okay? For someone, and passing through somewhere, and to talk about the parts of the day. So, I hope that this has been useful to you, and if you have any doubts at all, do not be afraid to ask, get in touch and ask about it, or just leave me a note down below. And guys, if you have not already subscribed, press the button down there, por favor, y hasta la próxima vez. Adios.